Rob Ballston's
Entertainment Week in Review.
Well, this past week, Amanda Bynes stated she wants to be on the next season of Dancing with the Stars, which makes sense if you've been watching the show recently, because apparently you no longer have to be a star to be on it. Personally, I feel like she's better suited for a different reality show. Maybe she could team up with Snoop Dogg and Lindsay Lohan for the first ever season of Are You Higher Than a Washington State 12th Grader? Yeah, they could play fun games like, what was I gonna say? Or positive role model, what the f*** is that? And my personal favorite, why the hell am I famous again?
That was my skull. I'm so wasted.
Well, this week it became official. Pamela Anderson is once again divorced from Rick Solomon. That's right, for the second time. In fact, this proves one thing to me. She's now been divorced numerous times. She's had failed engagements. I think it's safe to say Pamela Anderson's actually worse at relationships than she is at acting. Yeah. Well, it turns out Hollywood stars are turning to Tinder for love. I'm not making this up. Leonardo DiCaprio apparently is addicted to Tinder. And who else? Well, Hilary Duff went on her first Tinder date this past week. And as a true entertainment reporter that I am, I thought I should help hook these stars up with the perfect match. For Hilary, I thought a good, honest man, like this man, Pete, who says this in his profile. Things you need to know about me. First off, if we go out, you're paying. Not just for me, but my wife if she shows up. And she's a drinker. I dislike women who are not shallow. A plus is if you wear my mom's perfume and fit perfectly into the void she left. I'm 6'4". Those are two different measurements. Seems like a pretty good, honest man. Now, for Leonardo DiCaprio, it was a little harder. But I found this beautiful woman, goes by the name Oscar. Her profile reads like this. My turnoffs are males who are passionate environmental activists and more beautiful than most women in the world. All right, I didn't do enough research on that one.
And the Oscar goes to... Seal that up. Matthew McConaughey.
Rob Ballston's
Entertainment Week in Review.